What is going on, you guys? Deer Slayer 3000 back here with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be lifting. I'm going to be doing something completely different than what I normally do, in a sense, because, I mean, if y'all do remember, last video I ever uploaded, it wasn't even a video, it was just a stupid little short I made, which I probably shouldn't even made that, but it was basically like all the bulks going crazy or whatnot. That was like almost a half year ago. I remember I was back in May, I posted that. It's about the end of November, getting ready for hunt season here. And I'm still going absolutely nuts and never let off the gas pedal. So I've still been going crazy lifting. Now this is my home gym. You can see all those energy drinks I've drank. That was not in one day. Jesus Christ, I'd be in a hospital. But these are the weights that I use. Just standard barbell. Turning off the fan. I don't know if y'all can hear the fan going. But I got some like 7.5 pound plates over there, some 10 pounders, you know, not much. I mean, this right now is loaded on a 135. You know, the one of those big plates there is 25, 15, 10, and then those like metal little cast iron 10 pound plates. But anyhow, I'm getting off topic. We're going to be lifting today. I got arms and shoulders for today's lift. My schedule, my like workout schedule, Monday is legs, Tuesday, which is today, is arms and shoulders, Wednesday's a rest day, Thursday's chest and back, which I'm going to be doing a video for Thanksgiving. I don't know though, I shouldn't even say that, I might not be able to. I'm definitely going to lift, I don't skip lifts, but I don't know if I'll be able to record. Thursday's chest and back. Friday's legs again, Saturday's arms and shoulders, Sunday's chest and back, and repeat. So, 6 days a week, gets to be a lot. Over the summer, I was doing a little stint there where I would do upper lower, but my upper body workouts would take like 2 hours or over. And with school coming back, you know, you get home at 3, roughly is when I get back in the house here. And you kind of need to take a little nap, I do, because school wears me the hell out. So by the time I take a nap or whatever, you're looking at 4:30, taking your pre-workout. Okay, now it's 5 o'clock. Now you're going to finish working out by like 7:30. You got no time to do anything else really after that, because then you got to take your shake and your post-workout meal and whatnot. It just gets to be a lot. So I just went back to my old schedule where I started, and I'm not going to lie, it's worked ever since. So yeah, my pre-workout shenanigans here. I drink a Ghost Energy and I watch Sam Sulek. That's what I do pre-workout. And I also have a Pop-Tart because it's good for carbs. You know, they're good for carbs, builds your muscles up with carbs, in which equates to a good pump. That's the bro science that I know. There for a while, I'm not gonna lie, I was doing that. If y'all are into lifting at all, there's like a honey and salt thing. You put like honey, I think it's about a tablespoon of honey on a spoon, and then you pour some salt on it, and then you eat it. I've done that a little bit. I haven't done that in a few weeks, but that's another good way to get a good pump if you don't have pre-workout. I don't use pre-workout. I never have. Like I said, I just use Ghost for caffeine, but I don't know what specifically it's called, but in pre-workout, there's something that is supposed to give you a bigger pump or whatever, but I haven't tried it yet. I do really want to, but my mama kind of won't let me. But I do take creatine, you know, if we're getting into supplements and whatnot. I take creatine. Honestly, I might just have enough for today's lift. And I put it in my shakes. This is what I have now. It's Rise. This shit's kind of expensive, not gonna lie. That right there was like 50 servings for 20, I think it's $21, because that's all the store had. Normally I get this other brand and it's like $20 for 100 servings. So kind of just bought that because it's all the damn store I went to had. But I digress. I'm going to finish up this pre, feeling already hyped up, ready to go. And then we're going to cut to shoulders. Going to probably start out with some 35s lateral raise, but I normally don't work front delts in shoulders just because tomorrow, or not tomorrow, but the next lift I have is literally chest, where you're pressing and you're using front delts. And to be honest, most people's front delts are overdeveloped to begin with. So I do warm up. I take 10 pounds and just go like that. You know, use a band, you know, get your rotator cuffs and whatnot. All your important stuff up here, moving and warm and all that stuff. So, yeah, I'll cut to the lift then. I'll see y'all. All right, so I just finished up my warm-up set of 25 pounds. Now we're on a 35 for lateral raises. So let's get into it. Hopefully I don't get copyrighted with this music, because I don't have headphones. I do, but they're corded and only one of them works. And they're not very loud. So let's go. Good for a first set, boys. All right, I'm gonna try to lateral raise 50, but if that don't work, go right back to 35. I'll actually make it a drop set. So if I fail on 50, which I will, I don't think I've ever hit that before, then 35, and then right after that, go into 25 and try to do like some holding reps. Let's do it. 50s, I'm definitely gonna be swinging on. So don't judge my form, because I know it's god awful. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, nah. 50 is way too heavy for that. Getting fatigued early today. All right. Just a rest pause. All righty, that's good. All right, so now I'm just gonna do another set with the 25s. I think it's because I am kind of sick, not gonna lie, I've been sick for the last week, but I just can't do as much as I used to be able to, so I'm gonna go lighter, but I'm still gonna go absolutely crazy. So let's go do it. It's getting hot in here too, I had to lose the damn hoodie. Come on, get out of here, 35s. Put them back. That's another thing I love about lifting from home. You don't gotta worry about re-racking the weight right away. Alright, let's go do it. Oh, I could do heavier than that. Jesus Christ, yeah. Underestimated my strength, I guess. Alright, let's go back to 35. Whoa. And you take the 10s, you're nuts. Just hold those. starting to feel that a little way too much on my traps. Probably definitely swinging a little more than I should. Don't know if I'll record rear delts. Here, I'll mute this. Hopefully I don't get copyright strike from Alice in Chains, but not quite sure if I record rear delts or not. I take a resistant band and just go like this. Basically just face pulls, working rear delt. Sometimes I'll do bent over flies. Sometimes I'll sit on a chair and go like that. Basically do a lateral raise, but for your rear delts. So I don't know if I'll record that or not. If I don't, you'll see start of triceps. And if not, then obviously you'll see some rear delt work. Obviously I just did rear delt there, but kind of sore from last back day, so I might kind of just say that's it. Might do another little set of anything like that. I forget what it's called. We'll cut to that. All right, now for triceps, I just warm up using this the band that I use for rear delts. Just kind of do some light stuff right here, just to, you know, hopefully I can shut the hell up because it's annoying, but yeah, I'll just hold it there. It is good. Just put this thing on your door. Doing nothing but warming up right now. You know, we're not going even a little bit effort, honestly. This is just enough to get them a little warmed up, get the blood in them. And then switch sides. Y'all probably won't be able to see this side much because of the door. But then you do it with this one. Kind of go back and forth with this for a couple sets just to kind of get warm, and then I'll take like a 20 pound dumbbell or so and just do a warm up with maybe more than 20, probably like 30, and do some the overhead press with him. So now that that's done, a little bit warmed up, now we're gonna get into the heavier stuff and then skull crushers. So catch y'all up somewhere around there. Not sure if this is a bad angle or not for skull crushers, but I don't have a bench, so I just lay on the floor and do it. So let's go. This might be a little heavy. I just forgot I have 20, I have 30 on each side. Drop sit. Lose the 10 pounds quick and just absolutely go crazy here with some fast pumping reps. Ooh. How y'all doing? I'm doing good myself. All right. That was awesome. So, let's do it again. Get a little rest pause here and let's go nuts and finish off triceps. That is all. Let's go on, let's do biceps then, guys. All right, so for biceps, I just warmed up with the 35s and the band, you know, did some curls and whatnot. Now we're gonna go try to go crazy with the 50s. Like I just mentioned previously, I'm, you know, kind of getting over sickness. In the last arm day I did, you know, that's obviously on video, I did try to curl the 50s and, you know, I just wasn't as strong as I was prior, so. Who knows? Feels good today, so let's see how it goes. Try to do good form, too. That's all I got. Oh, damn, dude. But, that was tough. Definitely wish I got more. But, like I said, that's sickness. Now, obviously, I'm not using that as an excuse. I put myself up here. I expect myself to, to do better. But, anyhow, not really sure what I want to do now. Forgot to tell y'all, like, my weight and all that. Well, I was around like 170, close to 180 when I posted that video, that short, but I started at like 165 because I remember last year at hunting camp, there was a scale. And I step on it, now I have boots, jeans on, everything. Step on it and I remember it was in the 160s. And I told my dad, I was like, yo, that's not right. So we tested the scale. Completely fine. You know, we put a 35 pound dumbbell on it and it read 35 pounds, maybe 36 pounds, you know. It was right around that ballpark. So, that feeling hurt, not gonna lie. Like, I was like, damn, I'm a little twig. So, because at that time I was like 6'1". I'm 6'3 now, but bulked up to, I think, I weighed in this morning at 203, but at the same time, I think I had some water before then, so I'm probably like 201, but still, like, I've gained 40 pounds in under a year, because I started this back in, like, it was back February, January, somewhere around there. So, yeah, enough talk, get back into more biceps. All right, I'm going to do it one more time with the 50s. Might sway more. This time, just going for reps. Be a lack of carbs. I barely ate much today. Had a few eggs, some toast, you know, with dippy eggs. Had a frozen pizza and Pop-Tart, that's all. So it should be good carbs now. I mean, there's a good amount in the pizza and whatnot.
Oh, damn.
All right. So, now that we're done there, I might do... Let me do some bicep barbell curls.
Let's do that.
All right, boys. So now we're doing barbell curls. Normally, I do them on the easy bar, in which I did that with the skull crushers earlier. But I don't know if it's just an ego thing, but it kind of just feels more badass to do it with the straight bar. But I do have to say, you do notice some wrist pain, or you can experience it with the straight bar. So easy curl is safer in that aspect, but I just like the feel you get with this, with the outer bicep, so let's do it. Right now I got 35 loaded on each side. All right, let's go crazy with these. Oh, damn, dude. I'm trying to do something else. Just not feeling it today, dude. It's not the greatest. Still feeling sick, throat hurts. Just out of it, dude. And on top of that, I'm definitely gonna get copyrighted from these if I don't give a shit. Hell, my channel might get banned. I think I already have 2 strikes. Let's do some band work. This is very risky, because, y'all see. Actually, no, concentration curls. Concentration curls with the 35s we're doing. You get it, you just ride the negative out, you'll see. Do some assisted reps with it. This is a great, great workout. You get a chair, what you're gonna do, take the dumbbells, go like this until you can't do it anymore. And once you can't do it anymore, raise it, ride the negative out. You feel that burn, dude, I tell you. Oh, also put the pump cover back on. Let's do this. Oh, damn. Maybe I need to rest more, like rest periods. Good. All right, now that that's done, you do some if you want to check the pump and whatnot, you I'm gonna take the curls or the band and do some curls with them, pump as much blood in the muscle as possible. So let's quickly do that. It's pretty simple, actually, to get that band wherever I had it and just go to town. Thank you. All right, let's check the pump. All right, boys, let's check the pump. See how effective this lift was. Should be pretty good. I'm not gonna take the shirt off, but I'll roll up the sleeves and see what we're working with. Turn this on. Might be too much light. All right, we're good. So, hope y'all enjoyed the first video. Let's get after it. Maybe Thursday, not really too sure. You know, let me mute this so I don't get copyright. But whenever I do catch y'all, we're coming back stronger, boys. Let's get it, see y'all.